All right, what's up, everybody? It's that time again, Xcode 12 Beta 2. Been living with it for a week, so I think it's time to tell you about my five favorite things about Xcode 12. Let's get into it. So let's pop up Xcode here. I've got a new application that I've built. It's just a straightforward template out of the box is what I've got here. Now, the first thing, I'm sure you've probably heard about this by now, but the first thing that I just really appreciate is the new tab system. Never use tabs in Xcode 11 and the previous versions because it was just too clunky and I couldn't get along with it. But what you can do now is you can either right click or control click, and we have this open in tab here. Or the other way you can do this as well is to hold down the option key and click on a file, and it's going to open it up in a new tab. So we can just click through these tabs here. So for example, I could have another one with the assets, all these kind of things, right? And then I can just work through the tabs. So that's the first thing. That's number one. Number two, you will notice that this application, I've built it as a cross-platform application. And so what it's done, if I just close these up here, you'll see this. I've got a shared folder. This is where all the files that are shared between the platforms on my application would go. And then below there, I have a platform specific. So in this case, I've got an iOS and I've got a macOS. And if they're files specific to that platform, I can put them in this folder. And that's how that's going to work. Notice that there is also one here for tests, so I can have platform independent testing as well. Now, you know, not a big deal because you could create these groups, but it's just nice that out of the box, not everything is dumped into the one folder or the one group like it used to be at the root level. Now it all exists in, you know, these broken out platforms. So that's always nice from an organizational standpoint, and it's just nice to have that code sort of structured there for each of the platforms. So that's number two. Number three is to do with the preview over here, this live canvas. Now, you know, as you know, you can work with this live canvas in current versions, but what I can do here now, if I select, you know, I'm just gonna click preview or click on the outer frame, I'll just show you that again. And I click on this icon here, it's gonna bring up the inspector. So I can now change these options in the inspector right here. I can do the same with content as well. So if I click on the little Hello World text label here, not only does it get highlighted over here in the code as per usual, but I can also click on here and get the inspector. You will notice that it's sort of a similar inspector to over here. If I bring up these ones, you know, it's just a nice convenient way of getting to it there. So for example, if I'm on a small screen and I've got this tab closed, I can get to the same controls just by selecting whatever I want and then clicking on there. So that's nice. You know, it's just nice to have these here. I can also search and add modifiers as well. Just really nice to have that right there on the preview as I'm working. Number four is another one on the preview here. You can create new previews just by saying duplicate preview here. So if I click on this, you'll see that it's created a new one. I've got, there's the first one. I can scroll down to the second one. And I can change this to whatever I want, right? So maybe a landscape, maybe a different device, whatever. But that's just a really quick way to have multiple previews. Notice what it's done over here as well. It's created a group here for us automatically and put both of these views in the group here for each of the previews. So that's nice. You know, again, working on multiple platforms, working on multiple devices, it's just nice if you've got a powerful enough machine to keep everything running smoothly here. I'm on the MacBook Pro 16 with the i9. It's just nice to have these multiple previews right here. If you no longer want one, you can either just get rid of it, or you can just delete it from the code here and it's going to do the same thing. And then you're back to the one that you had before. So that's number four. Number five is somewhat related. You know, it's related to the tabs here. Hopefully you're familiar with Shift Command O, which is the quick open. Now, you may be wondering too, can you open up these files in new tabs here? And the reason I'm highlighting this separately is because you really should get used to this open quickly. It is such a great way of moving around Xcode without having to look through, you know, files, find the file and everything else. So let's say I want to open up the assets catalog. If I just type assets, you're going to see it's selected there for me. Can use the arrow keys to move around. And now what I can do, same thing, right? If I hold down the option and press return, it's going to open it up in a new tab. Right now, the two takeaways here, like I say, the Shift Command O is not new, right? That's been there before, but you probably may not be familiar with it unless you really sort of worked with it. So get used to using that. But the big thing being is that, again, you have tab control management, just like you do from the, you know, within the menus and everything else. So that's number five. I'm going to throw a bonus one in here, number six. What I'm going to do is I'm going to actually play this here. So I'm going to run this in the simulator. And then let's just switch over to the simulator. So one of the things I like here now is it's very immediately obvious which device you're looking at right here, right? iPhone SE second generation with iOS 14. And it's just real nice to have that there. You've got the home key and everything else like you had before. Plus you've got a rotation to rotate the device. Let me just move that across there. You know, but it's really nice to just have at the top of this simulator here exactly what's going on, and I can see which device it is. So if I'm running multiple devices, I can just quickly see, okay, this is the iPhone SE, you know, this is the iPad whatever next to it and things like that. It's just a nice little subtle change to the simulator, but an important one, I think. And of course, it's always nice to have the home button there, you know, which was on the previous one and that as well. So that's it. That is six tips instead of five. You got a bonus one at the end there. Just five things that immediately I'm really loving now that I'm working more with Xcode 12. I'm sure there's going to be more, plenty more to discover and like as we work with it longer, but that's my five initial impressions of things that are just really changing the way that I work with Xcode as I work through this beta version and start to introduce it into a daily flow to get used to these new controls, new everything else in Xcode. That's it. See you in the next one. Visit CompileScript.com for more.